Hi, this is Sean, and this is a demo showing some three techniques for doing skydomes. And you should also review your book from pages 304 to 310, where it will talk about skydomes and skyboxes for the environment that you have to create for your assignment. So, let's get to work. So you can see I've got my helper texture on three different half spheres, hemispheres that I've created. And you can also see that I've mapped it, each sphere, in three different ways in order to sort of accomplish this task. And I'm going to talk about the pros and cons of each in the next 5 minutes. So let's quickly get to work. First, let's get grab a texture from the internet. If you can, make it tileable. And you know, the wonderful tools in Photoshop now with a content-aware tool make this really easy. So we can sort of double-check this under Filter, Other, Offset, and you can sort of slide that around to double-check that you have a tileable texture. And there's no noticeable seams. So one of the things that you'll notice if I apply just the standard texture to these sky domes is that the standard spherical map will pinch right at the top. And you know, a lot of times you'll call that pinching at the poles is what it's called. And so one of the solutions that accounts for that is to do what's called a polar mapping distortion in Photoshop, and then do a planar map in Maya to sort of deal with that problem. And you can see there's a sort of like deals with it pretty well. So let's quickly show that technique. In Photoshop, under Select or Filter, Distort, Polar Coordinates, choose Rectangular to Polar, and that will create a map that distorts and squeezes that down. And then what you need to do in Maya is you need to do a planar map down the y-axis. So create UVs, planar map, y-axis, apply, and let's just take a quick look at how this mapped. So we'll go to the UV texture editor, and we can see we've got our hemisphere here mapped out. And if we look at the texture on there, it's sort of all sort of squeezed in there, and it looks pretty good. The problem with this technique is that it sort of stops you from being able to tile the texture. But it works. And you know, you also have the option of like selecting some of these UVs. Select an edge here. And if you convert that edge to UVs, and use the soft selection tool, you could conceivably like sort of change the texture density slightly by scaling up or scaling down the texture. And that gives you a little opportunity in terms of how you want to modify your the texture density. You could conceivably have more texture density if your character was going to get near the edges of the sky dome. So that's one technique. The other technique is just simply to let it live as a spherical map. And so let's do a spherical map on this object. So under Create UVs, we'll do a spherical map. And by default, since this was a hemisphere, it's still trying to map the sphere around the center point of this hemisphere, which isn't what I want. And if we look at the UV texture editor while we're doing this, see, it's not quite working the way I want it. So I want to slide that down. And I can do that by looking for this little red locator. So if I click on this, it will toggle the transform tool here. And so I can slide down the UV and just sort of get it just right over. And then you can sort of nudge it in place until you get sort of as good as possible of a UV map. And you might need to slide one of these UVs over just slightly. And then pack this all into the 0 to 1 space. And so you can see we've got a little bit of pinching at the pole. So how can we deal with that? Well, you can deal with that by sort of creating a combination of a spherical map and a planar map right at the top. So I did that in the final example that I'm going to show you. So let's go through that. We will do a spherical map again. Slide that down. And then at the very top, I'm going to select just that vertex at the top, convert that selection to faces, and then do a planar map just in this area where it's pinching. For demonstration purposes, maybe I'll go one larger. I think that we could probably get a decent result just on this small area, but here, let's go to planar mapping, and it's already set to the y-axis, and so now we've got two shells. One shell here, and this shell. And so I'm going to pack this all into the 0 to 1 space, the UV space. And ideally what you would do while you are sort of working on this is you would probably have your helper texture on the object, because your goal is to try to match the texture density of the surrounding UVs here to the top part. So sort of like adjust these UVs, make them a little bit larger, and if we bring this down, probably scale that into place, just so. And then what we need to do then is just go into Photoshop and make this work. So that's what I did. In this example here, I exported the UVs. So as a refresher, we go under Polygons, take a UV snapshot of the object in Object Mode. It has to be in Object Mode, and I exported a 1024 by 1024 UV snapshot. And in Photoshop, then, I created a texture where in the area at the very top where there might be pinching, or if I wanted to tile it, it's just going to tile blue right at the very top. And the rest of it is tileable on the U axis. And so if we apply the texture there, you can see this is the end result. We've got the blue area here on the top, and it looks like we need to nudge in order to make this tileable. I double checked, and this is the fixed texture. All I needed to do was just sort of nudge the UVs right to the edge there so it would tile appropriately. All right, so that's it. We'll see you in class next week.